Hey, what is up, you guys? This is Gray Fox, and we're playing some Fallout 4. Well, actually, welcome back to Let's Play Fallout 4. And I just found a sniper right there off a legendary super mutant. So I'm kind of sorry if it's a low quality. This is my phone that I'm using. So basically, okay, it's almost morning. Alright, so we're going to be continuing on with the main mission, which I haven't been doing for a while. It's a whole freaking week since I played this game, and a lot of crap has happened over the times, and I never recorded it. So I'm just going to quickly inform you that I leveled up. I'm a level 33. I got a crap load of different kind of perks. I discovered a lot of stuff. I found all the bobbleheads to the specials. I found a whole bunch of rare weapons, got new high-tech gear, I got my settlement upgraded, I gave my dog armor, I found all this crap over here, found a lot of stuff, and I haven't explored the Red Sea yet, but we're gonna, not the Red Sea, that's the Glowing Sea, but we're gonna be getting to that soon. I did a lot of freaking missions, completed a lot of missions, I haven't recorded anything else, but I wanted to only record the main mission, and then soon we could probably fool around for a little bit, not that way, but anyways, Let's get on. Let me show you Dogmeat right now. There he is, right there in his cool heavy armor. He's a little more protection. So I just got whole new armor here. Layered armor. Since I got a whole, I'm wearing nothing but rare armor. That's left arm. I wonder if I should wear that. That's gonna bring it down. Plus one in strength and endurance. I think you should tap that, or should I have my action points? Let's see how fast it makes. Regenerates it. Let me see. Let me check this out real quick. Okay. Nah, screw it. I'll just keep it like that. Okay, let's get it on. We're at Good Neighbor. Can I see that? Oh, shit. Okay. Where's the entry at? Oh, over here. So we gotta meet some doctor after we killed, Kellogg, which took our son that you saw in the beginning. Now, we took his brain. Now we gotta go and give it to some doctor.
Hold up there. First time in Good Neighbor? You can't go walking around without insurance.
You better back off, or you're the one who's gonna need insurance.
Well, hey, all right. We'll just say your insurance is paid up for now, okay?
Now, if someone steps through the gate the first time, they're a guest. You lay off that extortion crap.
What do you care? He ain't one of us.
No love for your mayor, Finn. Let him go.
You soft, Hancock. You keep letting outsiders walk all over us. One day, there'll be a new man.
Come on, man. This is me we're talking about. Let me tell you something.
Oh!
Now, why'd you have to go and say that, huh? Breaking my heart over here. Now, I know you had old Finn handled back there, but a mayor's gotta make a point sometimes. You all right?
I'm fine. Thanks for taking care of him.
Good. Now don't let this incident taint your view of our little community. Good neighbors of the people, for the people. You feel me? Everyone's welcome.
Yeah, I feel you.
Good. You stay cool, and you'll be part of the neighborhood. So long as you remember who's in charge.
Oh. You're liking this, aren't you, Dogmeat? Jeez! I just killed that guy in front of me!
Okay. A new player in Good Neighbor. Hello, little pawn. Welcome to our fun games.
Well, hello. Everything here is guaranteed to injure, maim, or kill at your discretion. Except me. I only kill when I want to.
Let's see what you have.
Each weapon tested on someone who deserved it.
Okay. Okay. Let's see what he has. I wonder if he has a rare weapon in here. Oh, yeah. You know, party starter. Against only against humans. That's it. That's the only rare. Oh wait, you got rare armor. Huh. Okay. That's it. That's the only cheap rare armor you got. This is where you can get copper as well. Okay, so let me just bring out my little James Bond pistol and let's get started. Never mind. This area looks awfully familiar. Oh! This part was in the trailer, okay. Okay, the memory den.
Mr. Valentine, I thought you had forgotten about the loan.
May have walked out of the den, Irma, but I'd never walk out on you.
Amari's downstairs, you big flirt. Here for Amari? She's downstairs.
Okay. Follow Nick.
Dr. Amari?
Yes. Wait, I know you. You're in the railroad. What's this all about?
We need your help, Doctor. I need the memories from a man named Kellogg. But he's dead.
I know it's asking for a miracle, Amari. But you've pulled off the impossible before.
Are you too mad? Putting aside the fact that you're asking me to defile a corpse, you don't realize that the memory simulators require intact, living brains to function.
Please. Nick told me you're the only one who can make this work.
This dead brain had inside knowledge of the Institute, Amari. The biggest scientific secret of the Commonwealth. You need this, and so do we.
Fine. I'll take a look. But no guarantees. Do you have it with you?
Here's what I could find.
What's this? This isn't a brain. This is... Wait. That's the hippocampus. And this thing attached to it? A neural interface?
Those circuits look awfully familiar.
I'm not surprised. From what I've seen, all Institute technology has a similar architecture.
Go on, Doctor.
Mr. Valentine is an older generation synth. But Institute technology being what it is, the brain implant could fit him. But that's... an incredible risk to take. We're talking about wiring something to his brain.
Don't worry about me, Amari. I'm well past the warranty date anyway.
I appreciate this, Nick.
You can thank me when we've found your son. All right, let's do this.
Whenever you're ready, Mr. Valentine, just sit down.
If I start cackling like an old grizzled mercenary, pull me out, okay?
Let's see here. I need you to keep talking to me, Mr. Valentine. Any slight change in your cognitive functions could be dire. Are you feeling any different?
There's a lot of flashes. Static. I can't make sense of any of it, Doc.
That's what I was afraid of. The mnemonic impressions are encoded. It appears the Institute has one last failsafe. There's a lock on the memories in the implant.
Tell me you have a way past this, Doc.
Let me think. The encryption is too strong for a single mind. But what if we use two? We load both you and Mr. Valentine into the memory loungers. Run your cognitive functions in parallel. He'll act as a host, while your consciousness drives through whatever memories we can find.
All right. Let's get started.
Just sit down over there and keep your fingers crossed.
Okay, I'm gonna take off my cap, my glasses, and my...
See you on the other side.
Jeez. This is in Fallout 3. I'll be back, dog meat.
Initiating brainwave migration between the transplant and the host. Mnemonic activity coming from the transplant. It's degenerated, but it's there. We're going to load you into the strongest memories we can find. They might not be stable. Just hold on. Can you hear me? Ah, good. The simulation appears to be working, although the memories are quite fragmentary. I'll try to step you through the intact memories and hope we find one that gives us some clue to the Institute's location.
What the hell?
There. This is the earliest intact memory I can find.
Oh, I gotta walk along these? Oh, dude, this is trippy.
Turn down the goddamn... I'm trying to sleep!
Remember, you are experiencing these memories as Kellogg. This may prove disorienting at first. Nothing, Connie. People like to talk and hope someone else is going to keep them safe. Teacher at school said the NCR would bring back the good old days, like before the big war. Don't you listen to that twaddle. I'm going to stop singing you if that's what they're teaching you.
I'm going out. Where the fuck did you put my boots?
Listen to me, Connie. You take this. You're old enough. You're the man of the family now. It's your job to protect us. Your father's useless, but you won't turn out like him. You're a good boy. And all that on the radio, all useless talk. The only thing that will protect you in this world is that gun in your hands. You need to learn to use it if you're going to survive. You've always been my good boy.
This doesn't seem to be what we're looking for. There appears to be another intact memory close to you in temporal sequence. There. Try that one.
Okay.
It's gonna be fine. You'll see.
But we don't know anybody here. And now, with the baby?
Come on, Sarah, you've got to give it a chance. I finally got steady work with a good outfit. Nothing like that in the NCR these days. Whatever made me think that a guy like me should have a daughter? No, I never deserved her. Not for one second.
No, I'm not saying this was a mistake. Are you sure these guys know what they're doing? They seem kind of green.
I know. But that's where I come in. Just you running my own crew. As soon as I make the connections I need. I was the worst thing that ever happened to her. If she'd never met me, she'd have stayed in the hub, maybe hooked up with someone who didn't kill people for a living. Probably been happier than she was with me. Almost certainly lived longer. Then I can give you anything you want. And little Mary, too.
Must be my mama instincts kicking in. Who knew I had those, huh?
Come on, you're great with her. And you don't even worry about me. Most of it's just running security for the she. A lot of standing around looking tough. The thing about happiness is you only know you had it when it's gone. I mean, you may think to yourself that you're happy, but you don't really believe it. Focus on the petty bullshit or next job or whatever. It's only looking back, by comparison with what comes after, that you really understand that's what happiness felt like.
Well, they sure picked the right person for that job.
Listen, it's gonna be great here. See this? This is what's going to keep you and Mary safe. I promise.
I know, Connie. I'm sure we're going to be really happy here.
We are. You'll see. That's okay. Got her.
Let's keep looking. I'll connect you to the next intact memory.
Holy shit. This is fucking intense. What the hell is... Oh.
How did you think this was gonna end, Kellogg? You thought you could just fuck with us, and we wouldn't fuck with you? Just so you know, they died like dogs. And you weren't there to help them.
I found another memory to try. I'll connect you.
Okay. All right, then. This is getting weird. Oh.
Sit down.
Suit yourself. There's always someone who wanted someone else dead. Sometimes just roughed up, but dead was usually what they wanted. Sometimes they thought they could cheat me. That was usually only when I first arrived somewhere. Didn't matter to me. I just took it as part of the job. Little extra thrown in for free. I always got paid in the end, one way or another. There was always a job for someone like me. Didn't matter what it was. Didn't matter who I was supposed to kill. I got pretty good at it. I don't remember much from that time. It all kind of blends together. There was almost always a bar, though. That's universal.
So, I hear you'll take care of people's problems. Is that right?
Oh, we'll pay you.
And you'll do this all by yourself?
That's right.
We pay you, and the job's done. Is that okay?
That's the way you want to do it. So who do you want dead?
Well, it's like this. There's his family. Lives down the creek with us.
Well, we seem to be getting closer. Try this next one.
What? Holy... His family lives by the creek way. I don't know. I wonder if they're talking about my family. Probably talking about my family or someone else's. Can't tell.
Mr. Kellogg, I'm glad you decided to meet with me.
So, you're with the Institute. I wanted to see for myself if you really existed.
We do, as you can see.
What do you want?
It's come to my attention that you've been rather disruptive of our operations lately. This must stop.
You heard all sorts of rumors about the Institute. But I figured they were just a convenient boogeyman for anything bad that ever happened. They were real, all right. They didn't know anything about operating on the surface. Relied on their synths for everything. They had the resources I needed, and I had the expertise they needed. Turned into a permanent arrangement. Suited me just fine. The first synths weren't all that impressive. I'm good, but I'm not that good. But the Institute could always make more, and kept making them better each time. They still give me the creeps, but you have to get used to them if you want to work with the Institute. What people pay me to do. If that's a problem for you, I could see only one way out.
And what's that, Mr. Kellogg?
If I'm working for you, there's no more problem. From what I hear, you can afford me.
I don't think you fully understand the situation you're in.
I think I do.
Very well. B-748, initiate.
Whoa!
I finally ended up in the Commonwealth. I kinda ran out of road. Plus, I'd come to terms with life. I wasn't gonna be stupid enough to get mixed up with caring about other people again. It was just me against the world. And the world had it coming.
Impressive. We may have something to talk about after all.
Getting warmer.
Holy
one of these
shit.
Has got to tell us something. We're running out of brain here. There's one that looks mostly intact. Connecting now.
Oh, this is it!
How's now the Institute's main operator in the Commonwealth? If they needed something done, they came to me. It wasn't usual for anybody from the Institute to come along on a mission, so this one stood out. They didn't know then who it was we were grabbing from the vault. Of course, neither did they. Not really.
Vault computers are still working. That's good. Checking through the logs. Hopefully it's all
just. Find them.
Pod C6, down the hall near the end.
I'm glad I didn't have to kill the kid. I'm not saying I haven't done it, but, I never liked to. And yeah, I guess it did remind me of, her. Yeah, I'm a cold-hearted bastard for sure, but, still human. Better this way, though. Better than taking her kid and leaving her alive.
Here.
Open it.
Is it over? Are we okay?
Almost. Everything's going to be fine.
Come here. Come here, baby.
No, no. I've got him.
Let the boy. I'm only gonna tell you once. now the Institute's main operator in the Commonwealth. If they needed something done, they came to me. It wasn't usual for anybody from the Institute to come along on a mission, so this one stood out. I didn't know then who it was we were grabbing from the vault. Of course, neither did they. Not really. At least we still have the backup.
Cryogenic sequence reinitialized.
Even then, I knew it was a mistake leaving him alive. I understood that kind of revenge. No one better. But I was cocky enough to assume I could handle some soft, pre-war vault dweller, even if he somehow got thawed out. At least I know those Institute bastards will soon get what's coming to them, too. If he could take me out, they won't be able to hide from him for long.
What's the holdup? I'm almost finished, Kellogg. I just need to confirm. All right, we're good.
I'm sorry you had to go through that again. I found another intact memory. Whenever you're ready.
I think that was the reason why they killed me. No, they didn't kill me. Because I would kill him, and then I would find the Institute, and I would... I'll just keep listening.
Is that your son? This appears to be a very recent memory, so good news, I think.
You're gonna get your head blown off just barging in here like that.
Minimizing my exposure to civilians is a priority.
Forget I said anything. So what's the big crisis this time?
New orders for you. One of our scientists has left the Institute.
Left? As in?
He's gone rogue. Name's Dr. Brian Virgil. We know he's hiding somewhere in the glowing sea. Here's his file.
Glowing sea. Oh shit, copyright.
Wow. Some heads are gonna roll for this. Capture and return, or just elimination?
Elimination. He was working on a highly classified program.
No kidding. One of the top bioscience boys? Damn. Wasn't my idea to settle down with the kid in the middle of Diamond City. I thought it was a terrible idea, actually. But it was one of the old man's pet projects, so here we were. Me and the kid, like a happy little family. I ended up kind of liking it. A reminder of what my life might have been if things had turned out differently. But there's no going back. I knew it was just temporary. It'd be back to normal business before too long.
What's going on?
His whole setup in Diamond City was part of some elaborate plan of the old man's. Seems obvious now that we were bait for our friend from the vault. Timing couldn't have been an accident. It's not how the old man works. I wonder if he outsmarted me in the end. Another loose end tied up. So, I guess you're taking the kid back with you.
Your only mission is to locate and eliminate Virgil.
You're taking me home to my father?
Yes. Stand next to me and hold still.
Okay.
What?
X688, ready to relay with Kellogg.
Bye, Mr. Kellogg. I hope I see you again soon.
Bye.
Teleportation. Now it all makes sense. Nobody's found the entrance to the Institute because there is no entrance. Let me pull you out of there as soon as you're ready.
Holy shit. Teleportation? Holy.
Slow movements, okay? I don't know what kind of side effects the procedure might have had. No one's ever done this before. How do you feel?
I'm okay, Doctor. Thank you.
That's good. But I want you to keep monitoring yourself. We have to be sure there's no long-term damage. Are you ready to talk about what happened in there?
I saw Kellogg's life. The man who ruined my family. The man I killed.
That's right. He was a human being just like the rest of us. And he had reasons for being what he was. However cruel, how does that make you feel?
It wasn't all his fault. I can't blame him for everything that happened.
If I were a priest, I would say forgiveness is a good thing. We're getting off track. The important thing is that we discovered the Institute's greatest secret, teleportation. The only question is, what do we do now?
That scientist Kellogg was supposed to track down. Virgil, we need to find him.
You're right. A rogue Institute scientist could answer all kinds of questions. Where did the memory say he was? The glowing sea? That doesn't make sense. No one goes there. Not even if they were desperate.
That's why he's there. To make the Institute think twice about following him.
That must be it. He's using the radiation in the glowing sea like a shield or a cloak, a way to throw them off and be at an advantage. If Virgil found a way to survive there, you'll have to do the same, if you're going to follow him.
I'll find a way to get through the rats. Don't worry.
Good luck, and be safe. By the way, I unplugged Mr. Valentine first. Remove the implant while you were waking up. He's waiting for you upstairs.
All right.
Nick.
Hope you got what you were looking for inside my head. That was right. I should have killed you when you were on ice.
What the fuck?
Kellogg? Is that you?
What? What are you talking about?
You sounded like Kellogg just then.
Did I? Mari said there might be some mnemonic impressions left over. Anyway, I feel fine, so let's get going.
What the fuck?
I'm gonna head out on my own from here, Nick.
Good luck out there. You know where to find me.
Well, what the freak? Jeez! Jeez. Dude, that's crazy. That is freaking crazy. I wonder if I can remove the song.
Hey everyone, gather around. Let's get the breathing. Now I know y'all are doing your own thing, but I don't want anyone here to forget what matters. Hey, Daisy, glad you could make it. How's my favorite girl doing? Didn't I see you on a date with Morowski the other day?
Otherwise, steal, better stay out of good neighbors.
All right, we're getting off track. What was I saying? Oh, that's right, what matters. We freaks gotta stick together. And the best way to stick together is to keep an eye out for what drives us apart. You feel me?
Yeah, you tell it like it is, Hancock.
Now, what out there in our big friendly commonwealth would want to drive us apart? What kind of twisted, unneighborly boogeyman would want to hurt our peaceful community?
The Institute and their sins!
That's right. Who said that? Come on up to my office later. You've earned yourself some jet. The Institute.
What the fuck?
They're the real enemy. Not the Raiders. Not the super mutants. Not even those tools over in Diamond City.
I don't know, Hancock. I'd sure love to give McDonough a kick in the ass.
Hey, we all know I got my own personal beef with that lardhead. But stay focused. Now, I want everyone to keep the Institute in mind when someone starts acting funny. When people are doing things they don't normally do. When family starts pushing you away for no reason. We all know who's behind that kind of shit. And the only way to stop it is to stick together. They can't control us if we're not afraid. Now, who's scared of the Institute?
Not us.
And which town in the Commonwealth should the Institute not fuck with?
Good neighbor.
And who's in charge of good neighbor?
Hancock! Of the people, for the people!
What, that freedom trail? What, you're some kind of... What are they called? Mystery buff?
Whoever this Brotherhood of Steel is, I'm not buying that we come in peace malarkey.
Jesus. Wow. So now we have to head to the glowing sea. I've been told about a lot about this, and I don't know what it is, but glowing sea, jeez. Exploring Kellogg's brain, man, that was crazy. So, whatever, there's a low, it's taking forever. All right, here we go. So we got a long way to go, so we're just gonna take a shortcut to the hardware town. Oh, snap. Now you teach him a lesson, dog meat. Alright, to the glowing sea. Let's go.
This shouldn't take long. Okay.
James Bond style. I love this pistol. It's so cool. Dangerous area, so I haven't been around here yet. Your brother's all loud. What's that? Yeah. Oh shit, that's fast. Like I said, I like this pistol. I'm not gonna take their stuff, I'm just gonna freaking... If I see a legendary one, I'm gonna take their stuff. I don't even have my cap on. Take their ammo.
Stupid little man.
Now I am playing on very hard as well. Oh, snap! Oh.
Baby scared.
That's cheap. We got in the cash. We got in here. Okay. And if I'm overweight as well, too, I can run. I can run as I'm overweight. Someone fighting over there. Here we go. What's that? Yeah. Oh, Jesus.
Hey.
You know those scents with the noises? They creep me the heck out.
Damn. Alright, let's search back in this place. I think you have to either go inside or... What was his head inside? But I'm not gonna do that. What does this pistol do again? Oh, it costs 25% less than, Oh, got him. Whoa, what's going on over there? Play ball, whoa! Whatever the hell's over here, better help them. Poison, huh? I could probably take off that scope.
Get back up.
where is he? I'll kill him. Man. Hey, there's a vault right over there. I wonder what vault number it is. Let's go check it out. Oh crap, gunners are overrunning it, huh? Okay, I don't want to deal with the gunners, and there's a fucking robot over there too. I don't want to deal with them. Let's continue with our mission. What's that green glowing thing over there? Edge of the glowing sea. Okay. I want to experience it now. Not yet. Well, even if I'm not even close to it. I think this is probably where they set off the nuclear bomb. That's what I'm probably thinking. But we're going to end it from here. We're going to explore the glowing sea in the next part. So, hope you guys all enjoy this part. And I'll see you all in the next Let's Play.